Hello, everyone, and welcome to Second Life University, a project that aims to provide informative content about the virtual world of Second Life. My name is Strawberry Linden, and today we will be getting some Jira tips from Second Life's senior QA manager, Kyle Linden. Thank you for joining us, Kyle.
Well, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
How are you doing?
I'm doing fine this morning. How are you?
I am excellent. So before we get into the tips, because I know they're really important and we have a lot to talk about, I do want you to tell us a little bit about yourself, what you do at Linden Lab, and how long you've been here.
Of course. I'm happy to share some of that with you. Where to begin? Well, at present, my role is, of course, a senior manager of the QA team for Second Life. But that is not where I started. I actually started as a resident in late 2006.
Yay!
I've been here for a long time. Yep. Mm-hmm. I started with an entrepreneurial goal of starting some business in Second Life and owned a few private regions. And well, I just had so many questions of support that eventually. One of the supervisors at the time, Harmony Linden, she said, you know, we're hiring. Do you want to apply for a job? And so I actually started out my career at Linden Lab on concierge. So I was there for several years before I moved over to QA, and the rest is history.
Amazing. So you got 16 years as a resident, 15 years as an employee.
That is correct.
Belt. And I hear that the rest of the QA team has a lot of experience under their belt, too.
Yes, it's pretty amazing. All told, we have over 90 years of experience testing Second Life.
Wow.
It's a lot of longevity on this team, a lot of deep experience. It's just an amazing team.
That is great to hear. So the reason I actually called you on today and practically begged you to come on is because residents often approach me with ideas for new features that they would like to see in Second Life. So can you tell us the best way for a resident to file a feature request? And also, I know it's through Jira. Can you tell us what Jira is exactly?
Yeah, absolutely. Jira is the application that we use to let our residents file bug reports and feature requests to us. It's a pretty powerful tool. One of the things that is unique about the way, maybe not unique, but uncommon about the way Second Life uses Jira is that we open it up to two-way communication. It can be conversational, whereas many other companies that use bug reporting software, it's really one direction communication. You submit the bug report and you hope that somebody's on the other end listening and hearing. But we will go back and forth and ask questions and really try and understand what the reporter means in their bug report or feature request.
So it's really detailed. That's great. So how do we file a feature request then?
The best way is to go to jira.secondlife.com, and you can do that in the viewer or in your web browser.
Okay, so let me actually do that while you're teaching us. So I opened up jira.secondlife.com, and I logged in with my resident account.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then what do I do next?
You would click the Create button.
The Create button, right here at the top, okay.
Yep.
Okay.
And now, are you filing a feature request or a bug report today?
Let's do a feature request first.
Excellent. So the project is correct. Mm-hmm. It is the bug project, but then on the issue type, you would select new feature request.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yep, you'll see the form changes to support the feature request submission.
Okay.
And you just start off with a summary.
So what would... like an example, so what if I wanted to do something to mainland, or I don't know.
Yeah, so maybe you want to make the sky green on mainland instead of blue.
Instead of blue, okay. Or maybe I want to put strawberries everywhere.
But there you go.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's the summary, and then
And then you just go into detail here and say, you know, across mainland, I want the sky to be green because that's much better than blue.
Because it's much better. Okay, so a lot of details.
Yes.
But of course, probably something a little bit more valid. But, you know, this is just an example.
Yes, just an example.
If you can't make it blue, then make this the moon strawberry. I don't know.
Sure.
Okay.
In this second area here, this is really where you've got to convince the committee that is reviewing these, and there is a big team, right? It's product, dev, UI, QA, and support. They're all there on a weekly triage, and we consider all of these submissions very, very carefully and thoughtfully.
Okay.
So this is really your chance to advocate for the thing that you want to see changed in Second Life.
So in other words, write a lot more than I just did right here.
Yeah, do screenshots, videos, mock-ups, anything that you can think of to support why you want this change to happen.
Okay. And then once you've got that and you've uploaded your file, either an image or video or whatever you're sending, then you just hit this create button.
That is it.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do that and see what happens. Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then click that link there at the top. The issue is bug.
Oh, yep. It closed. How do I open it again if I lose it?
That's a great question. So the quickest way to find all the bugs is in the search bar at the top. Yeah. Just type in bug.
Oh, it's right here. I guess that's the last thing that I opened. That's why it's showing me.
Right. That's your user history.
Okay. Excellent. Yep. And then it'll show. So say you do this feature request and you really want it to happen. You can share this link with your friends and they can vote for
correct.
It. Is that correct? How does that work?
Well, we don't really do voting, but others can comment on it and say, yes, this is such a great idea.
Yeah.
And other things folks might want to do is watch the Jira. Okay. There's a little watchers link there.
Yeah.
And then any changes that are made to this, we'll send out a quick little email that says we've accepted it, we've declined it, whatever the next step in the workflow is.
Okay. So that was pretty easy. What if someone has a bug, though, like wants to report a bug? Is it the same process?
It's very, very similar. And for bugs and for feature requests, the one thing I just really want to emphasize is please always use Jira. It is the best way to get your feature request or bug report to the right audience. So then for a bug, though, it is the same. You click create. It is also in the bug project. But then in the issue type, it would be bug instead of feature request.
Okay.
And then a similar process. You summarize it. Mm-hmm. You describe what happened, what was happening around you when it happened, all the relevant details that will help us quickly reproduce the issue and make it easy to understand. Now, that's the easiest way for it to happen. Oftentimes, bugs are hard to reproduce. They can be difficult to communicate effectively. So one of the things that really, really helps us understand what the bug is and how to recreate it is providing, again, screenshots, videos. Your Second Life log file is often a great tool for us as well to understand what's happening.
Okay. So the more details you can give, the better. And then you just
absolutely.
Hit the create button. So definitely, I know some people take the support ticket route, but that's not the correct route to take when you're requesting a feature or filing a bug report, right? Do it through Jira.
That is correct. And in the viewer, in the help menu, you will see that the submit bug report and submit support case are very near each other.
Mm-hmm.
But it is important to note that bug reports are different.
Okay. So what are the best practices to writing Jiras? Like what is most helpful to include? Just as much detail as possible, I guess.
And very easy to follow steps. Like
okay.
I logged in, I looked at the sun, my screen washed out white and stayed that way for the rest of the session. Just things that we can follow step by step. Or I logged in and the entire world was pink. That one's typically a graphics driver bug, by the way, and not our fault. You got to update your drivers on that one.
Okay, good to know. How long does, I just filed this feature request. How long does it take to get a response for a feature request?
Feature requests should see a response periodically. We do them like once a week. Sometimes they'll have that conversational back and forth, and then we'll say needs more information. But by and large, any new feature request is going to see some kind of a response, either accept or decline, within a week or two.
And so when people file feature requests and bug reports, usually it's for the viewer, but can we also file reports for web properties like Marketplace? Like if we want something added to the Marketplace, do we also file a feature request for that?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Many of our feature requests are, in fact, for the Marketplace and other parts of our web properties. So any part of Second Life as a whole can receive feature requests for it.
And how long does... how many feature requests and bug reports can a resident file? Is it just something that they're like limited to just a few, or can they file as many as they need?
Oh, as many as they need. Honestly, we don't want to get spammed, of course. Yeah. But if you have a never-ending supply of good ideas, keep them coming. We want to hear them.
Excellent. So I noticed that we don't have any questions that have come into the YouTube channel as of yet. And I think we've covered, did we cover everything? I wanted to give you an opportunity to share any other final Jira tips or any other recommendations you have for people that want to, you know, make sure their feature request or bug is looked at.
Yeah. One little tip I can leave is that when anyone files a bug report or a feature request, and as we saw earlier, if they are a watcher of that, whether they were the original reporter or someone who comments on it and says, yes, this is a great idea, please do it in support of the original post, you're listed as a watcher. And so when we either decline or accept, we will send off a little email that says that has been actioned. And then at the end of the life cycle of that bug report or feature request, when we submit it out to the world as a fixed product, and that will usually be done through a viewer release, there will be a notice again that says that issue is closed. So that is the final confirmation to the reporter and any watcher that the thing is fixed or the new feature has been released.
Excellent. So you do get notified every step of the way if it's, you know, it's in production or it's been done and so forth. That's great to know. Well, that was really easy. I know a lot of people approach me asking questions about feature requests, especially because they want this and that and in Second Life. So I hope you guys found this informative. Thank you so much, Kyle, for coming in today and giving this really brief but informative talk. And any last words to the viewers for us?
Again, thank you. But I guess the final thought I would share is just to remember that we're all people too.
Yes.
And we do care very much about these feature requests and bug reports. The QA team, with a mix of product and developers, look at bug reports daily. We do our best. We care very much about these submissions. We want to make Second Life a better place, and we really appreciate it when the residents give us this kind of feedback.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Kyle. Thanks to everyone for watching. We'll be back soon with more informative content for you. So don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and remember, everybody, to stay safe and stay virtual. Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.